Hi everyone, this is Mickey Adams with Mullen Pedal Steel Guitars in Dallas, Texas, and it's a Friday night and I'm home alone with my guitar, so I decided to try and do something constructive. Imagine that. So what I did was I picked the Easton Corbin song, I'm a Little More Country Than That. Of course, this was our favorite. This was Paul, obviously. And as always, you know, I may not get this exact, but we're real close. And we're always going to add our own flavor to it, I think, anyway. Even though copying someone like Paul is the most sincerest form of flattery, I would think. We're in the key of B. We're at position number 7. We're going to start off with strings 4, 2, 5, 4, 2, 5. Okay, and then we're going to strike 6. Depress the B pedal, strike 5. And then leave the B pedal down, slide up 2 frets with string number 6 again. We want to slur this one just a little bit as opposed to, right? We could use string 5 if we wanted to, but this one sounds a little cleaner to me. We're going to do the same thing again. 4, 2, 5, 4, 2, 5. Now we're going to strike 6, strike it again with a B pedal, and then string 5, and then string 8. And of course the electric guitar is an octave lower from us. The next run comes after the second verse. Now, although this sounds rather simple, it's actually can be a little complicated to get it exactly right. So let's start off with the E lever engaged at position number 5, excuse me, position number 7, and let's strike 6 and depress the B pedal. Let's immediately dampen and strike string 4 and move up a half step. Now I'm dampening with the back of my thumb right here on this G sharp. What I'm doing is just laying my hand down, and as I come back I'm going to leave this 4th string ringing and go ahead and depress the A pedal. So now I have A, B, and E at this point. As I slide back, I'm going to strike 5 with my thumb and raise the A pedal. My thumb again on 6 and raise it. Now you see my A pedal going down. As I'm moving up, now I'm at A, B, and E. That makes it nice and fluid. Good. Now the solo sounds like this. We're going to move to the B and C pedals and I'll play it through slowly. Us back into the E chord. So let's move over to the B and C pedals and let's lower string 2 a whole step for now. And we're going to use the C pedal. We're going to strike 5 and depress it, and then strike 2 twice. The C pedal again on 5. Now 2, 5, B pedal on 6, raise it and lower it. Engaged in string 2 lowered a whole step, I'm going to release these pedals and levers and I'm going to strike 3 and 4 and use the B and C pedals, raise them, move up 2 frets to strings 4 and 5 and move our foot over to A and B. This is 4 and 5 at 9. And then the A and B pedals. Now I always use A and B, although A is the only one that's really needed here because I'm building an E chord. Okay, now here we're at E major. Now we're moving up to the F sharp. A and B at 9, strings 4, 5, and 6. Glissando down to A and F at position 5. Glissando again to open at 2. Now we're going to use string 5. Now that from here, the A and D pedal is down. Now, I'm using a crossover here. We'll play it real slow. Right here to string four. String four with my thumb. One. And string number three with the B pedal engaged. That moves us into the E. Okay, here's the whole thing. Second part. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I welcome your comments. And this is Mickey Adams in Dallas, and I'll see you right back here with your steel. So long.